We are looking at partial derivative. In partial derivative, we have more than one variable. If we have two variables, we have three variables. Unlike ordinary differential, you have just single variable. Let's look at this. If you have w as a function of two variables, we can have the following notation. Partial differential, we can have x, same thing as what? Del w del x, which means we are differentiating the function respect to x variable. In that case, now we are keeping y constant. That notation, this is also equivalent to what f of x in this, which is also the same thing as what fraction. This will be del f del what del x. We can also differentiate this function respect to y, your x constants. You can write it in fraction notation, and that will be del w del y, which is the same thing as what f subscript y. We can also look at the ordinary differential. For ordinary differential, you are only having one function. You're having one function, and then you differentiate respect to what? Respect to that function. Find all the first order partial derivatives for the following. We have the first one, f of x, y is equal to x to the power 4 plus 6 times square root of y minus 10. So for the first one, we need the first order of the partial derivative. Question is, what are your functions? The function is what? The functions are x and y. So the first order partial derivative means we need this, and then we need what? We need the f subscript subscript x. We need f subscript y. Okay, let's go straight to the solution for the first one, which is the same thing as del f, and this we got to. We are doing a partial derivative respect to x. Other variables will be what? Will be kept as constants. You only differentiate that particular function. So this will be what? This will be 4x3. This 4 will go to the front. And then the what? The power minus 1. This one is a constant. This y is a constant. This one is also what? It's a constant. So that's my answer. Okay? So let's do the this one also. Respect to y, which is the same thing as del f del y. So in this case now, you are only differentiating just that variable. Any other variable in that equation will be constants. So look for y in that place. So this is your y. This is a constant. And when you differentiate a constant, it's going to give you zero. This one will be what? 6 times 6y to the power half. So that will be equal to 6 times half, then y, the power, that's half, minus 1. This one is a constant, so it's gone. So we have what? One will be y minus half. Okay, and that's equal to 3 over what? Over root y. Okay, so that's the first order partial derivative. Yeah, the second one. Here we have w equal to x squared y minus 10 y squared z cube plus 43x minus 7 times 4y. So we want to find the first order derivative. So in this case now, w is a function of three variables, and that will be equal. When you are doing partial derivative respect to x, all other variables will be kept as what? As constants. So in this case now, I'm only differentiating x squared, and that'll be 2x. This one is kept as constants. Then you come back here, there's no x here. So the two variables are constants. So that one is gone, this one is zero. Here we have plus what? Plus 43. Okay, this one, there's no x variable in this place. Then we can also get w subscript y and z is constant in this case. So what you need to do is just to look for the variable y and differentiate that partially. So this one is differentiated respect to y. So we have what? We have x squared in this place. Here, in this place, I'm only differentiating y squared. Why this and this are kept as constants. And that will give me 2 times 10, that's like 20. And then the power here, minus 1, so I have y z to power 3. Then here, there's no y here, so that's 0. Here, I'm going to have the derivative of tangent is sec squared, the function, and then times derivative of the composite function, that's 4. Derivative of 4y is 4. So 4 times 7, that's minus 20, 28. And that's that on the w subscript y. And the last one, respect to differentiate w partially equal to. That means in this case now, your x and your y are constants. So here, there's no z in this place. Okay, we only have it here. I'm differentiating in that place. And that'll be 3 times 10, that's minus 30. Y squared is kept. And this would be what? Z to power 2. No, power minus 1. Okay, there's no z in this place. That's 0. In this place also, there is no z. So that's the that's that on these first order partial derivative. At this point, kindly smash the watermarks on the video bell and hit that notification bell so that anytime I upload, you get notified. Don't stop there. Click on the like button. And finally, share the links on all your social media platforms. Thank you for doing that. For the C part, the age is a function of two variables, x and t. Okay, so we're going to differentiate it, the function, partially, respect to x. Okay, and don't forget, this is the same thing as what? Del age or what over del. So what this means is that we are only spotting the x function. Any other function that is not x is constant. Okay, so t7 will be constant. Okay. Differentiate the ln, and that will be equal to what? 1 over s squared times what? Derivative of the of this inner function, that's 2x. Okay, that's how to differentiate our ln function. Let me quickly explain that. If you have ln of f of x, you do the s of this function, it will be equal to what? F prime of x over what? Over f of x. So that's how to differentiate our ln function, natural logarithm. Here, there's no x there. So this is 0. That's constant. Here, I'm going to do the algebra there. So that will be x 4 over 7. Remove that radical. Okay, so this will be this. Then differentiate that. So we're going to have minus, the power will go to the front, 4 over 7. Then x 4 over 7 minus 1. So if you like, you can remove this minus 1. So if you like, and that will be equal to, if you do that, that will be equal to. Okay, so that's that. Let's do the respect to the respect to another function, respect to t. So respect to t, that means x will be kept as a constant. You only differentiate t when you are doing partial derivative respect to what? Respect to t. So we have this one. So that'll be what? That'll be 7 t 6. The 7 go to the front, and then the same t. The power minus 1. So you keep this one as a cost. Then this one, let's write the algebra of that. That will be, that's 9t minus 3. Okay? And that will be equal to plus 9 times minus 3. T, this one, that's minus 4. So this one is a constant in this case. So it's gone. So we have this one. Okay, please. There's watermarks on the video. Quickly smash the watermarks and subscribe. That is one of the ways to advance this channel. Okay? Click on like button and begin to type your comments. And I promise to respond to your comments as fast as possible. Share the links of this video on all your social media platforms. Thank you for doing that.